Ah, peace to the Saints. Peace to the Saints. Shout out Kenny B for starting it off. You see, my smile is extra big today, Saints, because we have some serious work to do today. Now, this talk will be about human nature and how to deal with your enemies. And I have a special treat for you, Saints, that today we shall have a few case studies. And at the end of this lecture, and I invite you to stay till the end, because this is going to be, as was said in the comments, a real pig roast. You dig? There was a gentleman who had the big homie's name in his mouth, which is all fine. Shout out to the individual, you dig? He did me a favor and broadcast my name to his 120,000 or whatever many followers. And now many of them are joining this cause. But let us start with a small introduction on human nature, on how to deal with your enemies, and then I'm going to give you an example of how to deal with your enemies, just a little taste. And what we're going to do is we're going to analyze the most recent events that have to do with some suckers. Oh, it shall be an epic YouTube roast, I promise you. Stay to the end, you dig? Because my team damn near provided me a dossier. Is that the right word? A dossier? Just a whole bunch of information? Oh yeah, it's beautiful, Saints. You're going to want to stay till the end. Trust me on that. Number one, I was reading this great text called The Black Box. And within it, there are many notes on human nature. And it's so important because you may be observing my moves, chess moves, and though you are playing checkers, like, because you're playing checkers, you're not understanding. So let me clarify some things. This is a manual to the good life. Check this out. In the black box, I wrote, and you're going to see how this connects to today's situation. It's amazing. People have said, Marquette, how is it that you came into the YouTube game catching bodies, biting people left and right, disrespecting people, and someone even say hating on people as though it's a crime to be critical of someone whom you disagree with? We have all these alpha males, yet they are scared of competition. And they would disparage you for being competitive when the true reason they disparage you for being competitive is because they are scared of the competition. They are scared they will lose to the new competition. Now, let me tell you why. Here it is written in plain language in this book. Page 45. The chapter is Gangsterism 101. It reads, quote, anytime a male comes into a new environment, he enters an existing power structure. The other males will challenge him to see where he fits in. Their inclination is to push you to the very bottom of the hierarchy unless you assert otherwise. Now that tells you everything you know. When I came into the YouTube game, they want to push me to the bottom. Why? Because if they're at the top, they want to stay there. Because they know that for me to eat from the pie, I got to snatch food off of their table. So of course they're going to try to push me to the bottom. But take that quotation and then add this other quotation also from the book, which teaches you how to operate, how to win, and how to thrive. It's from the very end of the chapter entitled Swing First, Chapter 2. It reads, quote, this experience taught me three major lessons. Number one, empty threats are only dangerous to those who deliver them. Which is to say, if you make an empty threat, it's not dangerous to the person you were talking to. It's dangerous to you, because people find out you're a sucker, and you will be exploited. Lesson number two, if you threaten, you must over-deliver. Yeah. That's why I always tell you, I will kill an ant with a sledgehammer. And I really live like that my whole life. Check my G-File. Number three, it reads, quote, swing first. A single punch can begin and end a fight. Which side of that punch would you rather be on? The chapter is called Swing First. Now let me tell you what the knowledge is. Put these two quotations together. The first quotation says, when a new male comes into an existing power structure, they try to push you to the bottom unless you assert otherwise. Unless you take your position, they will push you to the bottom. And I just told you, swing first. When I came in this YouTube thing, I came in swinging first, giving out black eyes. Huh? Yeah, big bad wolf. Should not also read in that chapter, it said, empty threats are only dangerous to those who make them, which means I don't make empty threats. You dig? Now, shout out to the young man who had my name in his mouth. I looked at his roast. I thought it was chuckle-worthy. So, I chuckled. And I was just going to leave it at that. I wasn't even going to respond to him because it was chuckle-worthy. But here's the thing. Me, I consider it business. You roast me, no problem. My ego's enormous. It would take a mountain to crush it. You dig? I can take a roasting. But what I don't do is when you talk about my employees, you talk about my women, you talk about my family, you talk about my loved ones, you attack the assassin, any of those things, it becomes personal. Attack Marquette Devon Burton. Thick skin. But you attack my people, then it's a problem. You dig? I was going to let him slide. I messaged on his video. I said, hey, oh, let me give you a little bit of background in case you don't have it. Let me give you a little bit of background. Long story short, there was a gentleman who I'm going to show you him, and I'm going to show you how everything started. But long story short, there was a gentleman who saw a video I made about the women in Brazil being average. And what I mean by that is people exaggerate how attractive these women are. And I'll tell you why they do that later. And I said, yeah, these women are average. They're no different, really, than the women you would find at Venice Beach, California, huh? Or Malibu, California, huh? Or Miami, huh? In the United States, there's no difference. They got butthurt over that. And one guy decided to roast me, but here's what happened when he tried to roast me. Now, pay attention. This is also in the black box. In the black box, I write the following. In this book, explains the whole world. It says, when someone finds you to be their superior in every way, they cannot attack you. So they attack that which is to the side of you. They attack circumstances, which is to say, he looked at me and said, this guy's more accomplished than I am. He's more educated than I am. He's better looking. He's better built. Has more money, more experience, more respected. What can I say? I'm going to attack the woman holding the camera. So he attacks the woman who's holding the camera because he can't attack the big homie. But you guys are probably wanting a little bit of background information. We gonna do it. Hey, and check this out, Saints. Pay attention to the very end because it's just gonna get hotter and hotter and hotter. And I promise you, this will be one of the most epic roasts of all time on YouTube. Because unlike these other YouTubers, I got a whole team to do my bidding, you dig? And they did a great job at research. Check this out. I'm going to give you the whole play-by-play. Shout out to the folks paying their tuition. I truly appreciate that, Saints. Thank you, Kenny. Let me go ahead and do this screen share. You heard me? Check this out, Saints. Oh, this is going to be a beautiful, beautiful thing. Oh, I enjoy it. I enjoy it. Let me see if I can maximize this. I want you guys to know exactly all the background on this because this was such a beautiful thing. We're going to teach some lessons, Saints. We're going to teach some lessons. Now, for all of you online, let me show you how this whole thing started. I made a video saying that Brazilian women are just average, just as any other woman around the world. And in fact, when I was at the beach, Copacabana, and when I was at Ipanema, which are well-known famous beaches in Brazil, I noticed a lot of fat women, just the same way you'd notice a lot of fat women in America. And here's the thing, I've been to Brazil before. This is not my first time in Brazil. I've been to other cities in Brazil, so I can speak intelligently. I've also been around the world. You dig? So this is an educated opinion. People got butthurt, but you want to understand, why did they get so angry? Why were people so angry that I said Brazilian women are just aight? I'm going to tell you why. They were angry because when these guys come to Brazil and they show you photos of all these gorgeous women that they're with, those women are prostitutes. Shout out Brian. Says peace to the assassin. Those women are prostitutes. And the reason they come way down to Brazil on a 14-hour flight, because you can come here and the quality of woman prostitute that you get for $30, which is like 150 Brazilian real, gorgeous, gorgeous. And they take pictures with these chicks and they have what's called a girlfriend experience, which is when the pimpin' allows the female to kiss the guy in the mouth and make him feel good about himself. or they pay for the whole day, maybe for $100 US, and they get to take flicks and show receipts. And really think about it. If you were worth anything, would you have to travel all the way halfway across the planet Earth just to find a good-looking woman? That's silliness, right? And they do the same thing in Brazil and Colombia and the Dominican Republic. This is what they do. So when Marquette came here and said, these women are average, which is true. On average, you just pick a random Brazilian woman out of the hat. She's just high. She's just high. Now, they do have some gorgeous women, yeah. And the prostitutes are often very gorgeous, but you gotta pay to play. And these boys are paying to play. So when I consulted in their minds, Brazilian women, I was talking about their girlfriends, their fake girlfriends, the prostitutes they use, so they got mad. There's entire travel groups of guys who come down here just to trick money on prostitutes, and we gonna talk about them. You hear me? We gonna talk these facts, you dig? And hey, here's how you know the big homie is a real one. People say, Marquette, you hate. No, I don't hate. I keep it real in a fiat issue. You dig? 10 toes down. Just hand me a whistle. Hey, check this out. I made a whole video saying, do not deal with easy women and prostitutes, because I know that will destroy you. That's love. People aren't watching a video called Don't Use Prostitutes, but I made that because I love you. I don't want you to end up with communicable diseases that are going to prevent you from having a good woman in the future. You dig? That's love. Now, check this out. Let's get to it. Now, here's where it all starts. I want you guys to see that this post right here is by a guy named Aaron Ferris. And we're going to talk about this nerd. What he has right here is a photograph of the big homie. You dig? I'm recording the video for my patrons, for my members. You dig? The members at www.thesasn.com, as well as the members at patreon.com/thesaintsandthesinner spelled out. Apparently, your boy is getting famous because I'm walking down the street and getting recognized in foreign countries, so apparently your boy is a big deal. Hey, shout out, I appreciate it. Now check this out, shout out to the SX Moneymakers for the super chat. Now here's the funny thing. This is after the video I made about Brazilian women being garbage. This is my second video. So this guy saw that video, got mad at me, and him being an alpha male, instead of confronting me, I was clearly right there. He walks past me, looks at me from the back, behind my back, and takes a photo behind my back. And here's the worst part, Saints. Look how far this guy is. This nerd is like 8 football fields away, taking a photograph of me with a sniper lens, because he's so damn far away. He damn near in the nosebleeds taking a picture so far away, because he's terrified. Now, here's the difference between a guy like me and a guy like him. Hey, if I don't like you, if I got a problem with you, I promise you, I'll bring it straight to your face all day, every day. I don't care who I'm with. I don't care who you with. You can be with your grandmama and your baby. Yeah, we're going to address it. Where I'm from, we call that on sight. This dude's a nerd. He took a picture of me from 1,000 feet away. That's because he's scared. But here's the guy who took the picture is Eric Spencer. The guy who posted it is Aaron Ferris. He writes, quote, when I say we got boots on the ground all over the world, I mean it, fellas. This brotherhood of traveling men is not a brotherhood because you don't stand for any values. A brotherhood of traveling men is powerful. No, you're not traveling men, you're tricks. It's a brotherhood of people who go to Latin America to buy cheap vagina. You are a trick and you are despicable, but I still love you and I hope you are healed from that. Yeah. Now, he wrote Mr. Macadocious, the saint and the sinner. His girl was the only one that looked like trash on Copacabana Beach, LOL. Well, if you really feel that way, let me show you guys what kind of person I am. They say they're in Brazil in Copacabana. I'm in Brazil in Copacabana. Let me make you a promise. Tonight, when I get off of this live session, I'm going to tell you what I'm about to do. I'm going to put on my workout outfit, and I'm going to go straight in front of the Fairmount Hotel. I'll be there doing pull-ups, shadow boxing, and jump roping. Any one of you nerds, or all of you nerds preferably, I dare you, I double dog dare you to show up to have a conversation. I promise you, you wouldn't make eye contact with me. So I invite all of you. I will be there by myself. I invite you to come. I invite you to come. promise you I invite you to come. Since you guys are, you know, tough guys that you take a photo 3 football fields back and then you run your mouth, not about me, but about a female taking a photo because you ain't got nothing to say about me. And here's how much of a nerd you are. You were so scared you had to take the picture from the back. Yet you called the girl ugly. You don't even have a picture of her face. That's corny. Here's what's worse than that. Now consider this, Saints. I really want you guys to know this because I mean this. I wouldn't care if a woman was fat, had a bum leg, and a lazy eye. As long as she can keep her good eye on the prize, you dig? Because real men want a real woman, a woman who contributes. A guy like me, I've had bad bitches my whole life. Check the receipts, they're all over the place, you dig? I got bitches so loyal, they'd kill you for me. Believe that. That's hey, check this out. I got chicks who are gorgeous from around the world hopping in my DMs literally every day. And that's not from YouTube shit. That's from before YouTube. It's doubling up and tripling up now. I can't lie to you. But hey, let's be real. Look at him and look at me. I'm going to show you guys what he looks like. And you let me know if they should be talking reckless. You dig? This stuff is crazy, man. Now, how is it they going to talk reckless about me? Look at me and look at my whole life. Can anyone reasonably say they don't think I get bitches? When I was 5 years old, grown women would tell my mom, your son's so pretty. Why his eyebrows look like that? Where you get his eyebrows done? When I was 5 years old, and my mama had to tell him, God made him like that. God wanted this boy to be pretty like that. You heard me? Yeah. Grow natural, just beautiful. You heard me? And this is my face after boxing with scar tissue on my nose. Like, come on, man. Give me a break. Yeah, I'm talking crazy because I really feel that way. Now, check this out. Let's continue with this evidence. Pay close attention, Saints. Shout out to the Super Chat, by the way. I see you coming through. I appreciate that because we got some serious work these boys going to get. New ideas sends through the Australian dollar rights. You desperately need to hear your message. True. I'm 38 now, and I can only wish I received your lessons when I was younger. Respect to the teacher. I truly appreciate that, because these young boys going down to Brazil, having a good time, but leaving and coming back with herpes. I mean, I'm just keeping it real out here, because you can't protect from that with a condom. You dig? I'm just trying to look out for you guys, because I know why you come down here. And one of the cats in this kid's comment section, they said, Marquette to sand to the beach. Let me tell you something that you don't understand, because you're a loser. If you were a super player like me, and you're a real boss like me, you can bring sand to the beach, bring your own sand, and you can also pick up new sand while you're at the beach and make a sand castle with all of it together. Because you're really running shit. You do what you want, you bum-ass niggas. Only a loser would talk about bringing sand to the beach because he's basically saying the underlying truth that his female is going to regulate what he does. I do what I want to do, you bum bastards. You bum bastards. Confidential rights. Cook them, big homie. Oh, I'm just getting started, man. This is only foreplay. We just getting these pussies wet. You heard me? Check it out. Carrying on. So this nerd, Aaron Ferris, he's the one who runs the Black Men Travel Group. He's the nerd that posted up this photo. And just a side note, I look great in the photo. I'm looking at the muscular development of the shoulders, man. Those pull-ups are really working out. You dig? I'm not surprised he was scared to walk up on me, man, because I look intimidating. Apparently, he was intimidated, the sucker. Now, look at this little dude right here. Look like a skinny-ass Rick Ross. Look like Rick Ross when he didn't had a diabetic episode. Skinny bastard. And he ain't even got a full beard like he's sick. He probably got AIDS. That's why he probably be going around having sex with all these prostitutes. Now, look at his LinkedIn. He's broke, okay? Let me show you something, Saints. Check this out. I want to switch to his LinkedIn real quick just so you guys can see what broke looks like. You dig? I want you to see what broke looks like. Here's an example. Just real quick, you dig? Check this out. This is what broke looks like. He looked like a Suge Knight that been homeless for a couple years, man. He got the little chin strap beard. He ain't got no hair on his head, but he got the nerve to start the sideburns from the top of his ear. This is a funny little monkey right here. Okay, now here's the thing. He went to University of West Georgia? Never heard of it. And his experience is from a company that doesn't even have LinkedIn photos. Okay, yeah. And he wrote and produced a film called Cocaine Diaries. Looked like he's sniffing cocaine. And that's it. That's all of his information. This is what being broke looks like. There are no accolades to this man's name. He's what you might call a loser, okay? He's a loser, and it's okay. My major work is to teach you guys not to be losers like this guy. But hey, he ain't done getting that work. I got 2 more people to roast, and I'm easing in, okay? So please, please pay attention. You dig? Only one Carter writes, easy work. He ain't never lied. And you guys ain't even seen what I got in store. I mean, check out what I got in store. Carter, you gonna love it. You gonna love it. Check this out. We going back to it. They ain't done. And here's the funny thing about these nerds. They're petty. That's why they came at me, because they're petty. But I'm ruthless. And they're about to learn the difference between petty and ruthless. We're going to teach them. Because I really am what I say I am. I'm everything that I say I am and a little bit more. Because there are things I didn't write about in the black box because it's not past the statute of limitation. There are things that are not in the black box I can't write to my dying day to protect the guilty. You hear me? Hey, but they're going to find out the hard way. Check this out. Francis, formerly known as CIA, writes, laugh my ass off. Stop this show. The face reveal said it all. Exactly. He's a bum. He's a bum. But let's get back to him, because we ain't done with him. Now, here's the thing. These boys be on the internet faking. They on the internet faking. Of course they hate me, because I'm the only real one here. We went to his LinkedIn. He's a phony guy. He has no accomplishments. Runs a travel group, but he only has evidence of being in Brazil, Colombia, and the Dominican Republic. Any black man, hell, any man, white, black, blue, purple, green, you know, these are three clubs of sex tourism. Tell me I'm lying. Brazil, Colombia, Dominican Republic. That's where black guys go to have sex with chicks who have big butts that have been artificially enhanced. That's where they go. He's going directly to the hubs of sex tourism. Huh? This dude's a trick. He's an unrepentant, proud trick. And of course he hates me because I'm the opposite of the trick. You dig? The pimpin'. Evan writes, sheesh. Marquette to vouch, I had to dish an empty thread at this cat from work. 5-star catering hall. Talking shit. Statement left my presence vapid and wide open. Best believe, lesson learned. Absolutely. Never issue the empty threat, say. Always make sure you deliver. It's always better to say nothing and do the most. You hear me? Now check this out. We not done with this sucker. Here's the thing. He runs a travel group. He's only been to 3 countries. I don't run a travel group. I've been to 45 countries. And I would take out the time to count them to you, but I ain't got that kind of time. It's that many goddamn countries. This dude's a bum. Now, he writes, this is one of his posts from YouTube on his YouTube channel. He has like 7,000 followers. Now, his buddy called me a struggle YouTuber because I have like 47,000. But this guy has 7,000, but apparently he's cool. That's fine. Now, here's the thing. If we play Big Bank, take Little Bank, we line up my bank account with the cat I'm about to show you in a couple minutes. Well, who's really struggling? Yeah, go for the things that really count. YouTube count don't count. The money always counts. Yeah, now check this out. This bum writes, crappy strip clubs in Atlanta look nothing like this. The girls here are, quote, very aggressive. They love American men. If that's not a trick, what is? He's basically saying that the women in these clubs, which they don't have strip clubs in Brazil, the Dominican, and Colombia. Those are not strip clubs. Those are whorehouses. Those are whorehouses, brothels, places of prostitution. And he's saying they're aggressive and they love American men, which means they don't like you. They don't like you for you. They like you for what you can give them. This dude's a bum. And why does he have to go to prostitutes? Because he ugly. He's ugly and has no game. Now here's the thing. He's showing right here. He's in Brazil currently. Open invitation. Let me enlarge my face so you can see I'm serious. See, it's real. Open invitation, nerd. I'm going to be in front of the Fairmount today after I finish this live. Pull-ups, shadow boxing, jump rope. Hey, I even invite you. Come after I'm tired. Come after 2 hours of me going in covered in sweat. I still mop your ass up, boy. And I would love to do it out here. It's on site. I invite any and all of you. Yeah, I'm really like that. I really be out there. Because I be out every single night I've been out here. I've been in the same spot. Come see me. And I know you know where I am because you nerds are taking photographs of me. And one of you nerds posted in your group, I saw him and his assistant having lunch. Well, then say hello, man. Don't be scared. Here's the thing, though. I terrify you suckers. Because you guys ain't never seen a real alpha male in your life. Every time there's competition, you guys get scared and say, oh, don't hate on people. You're hurting people's feelings. You guys are suckers, man. It's laughable. Now, let's carry on. Carrying on. Here's their travel group right here. How you guys gonna insult me? How you gonna insult a woman holding a camera, but you guys sitting here, 5 grown men and 0 bitches? Now, I'm trying to do some math. I'm adding up the men. It's about 5 of them. 5 hot dogs, 10 balls. 5 hot dogs, 10 meatballs. And 0 holes. Where they do that at? And you in Brazil with all them fine women, but you're sitting there with just a These dudes are weirdos, but they talking palmito. That's crazy, man. And I'm just showing y'all the facts. Damn, you got receipts, bro. It's just started. It's just started. Call your mama in to watch this, you hear me? Because I ain't even brought up Nostradamus yet. Wait until I bring up Nostradamus. You got to see this other guy. Woo, you wouldn't believe it. Jabrisi Magic writes, damn, Quet moves quick, turn this around, less than 24 hours. Hey, man. I'm telling you, I got a beautiful team that I'm so thankful for, and that's why when they disrespect my people, you hear me? I'ma get in their ass. Yeah, absolutely. No homo. Oh, and speaking of homos, stay tuned. There's one of these guys is actually gay. Yeah, for real. Nah, I'm not saying he's gay. I'm saying literally a homosexual. Stay tuned. Yeah, you gonna love this, Saints. Appreciate the super chat. Johnny G. Right, don't forget Korea about sex tourism, but I'd love me a square that keeps my paper up. Absolutely, baby. We all need enemies. Hate is a fire for the real. Oh, man, if you ain't popping, you probably won't have no enemies. But if you're popping, you gonna have some enemies. If you stand for something, you stand against something. So surely there will be people organizing against you. But let me let you know this. No weapons formed against me shall prosper. That's why I'm always walking around with a smile. You dig? Get my chest out around the whole planet Earth. And I've been doing that my whole life. Now let's get back to these suckers. Carry on. Now look at this nerd. Now here's the thing, man. This dude is folding like a hoverboard board, and he took a picture with it like a big-ass kid. You gotta be a real nerd as a grown man to even buy this. No disrespect if you got one at home, but I'm just saying. He's a nerd. And here's the worst part. You only really take pictures with big, expensive things that you're really proud of, right? This dude took a picture of himself with a hoverboard. He's clearly broke. And just look at this nerd. And why do I say nerd? This dude is wearing a sweater vest. What in the... This boy wearing a sweater vest. Yeah, and it looks like he's holding a Bible. Look, son. Hey, you better stay your ass in church and quit playing with me before I turn in the center on your low ass, boy. Hey, and I'm talking big shit. And guess what? Not only am I talking big shit, I'm inviting y'all suckers out right in front of the Fairmount. As soon as this live is over, I will be out there dulo. Dulo. Yeah, ready. Be there. I'll be there, sucker. Now, mind you, two of these guys have already seen me, said they didn't say a peep. They were quiet as a church mouse. Huh? Who's the big dog, huh? I'm all up in their country, they scared to come out. Now, let's carry on with these nerds. Now, let me show you how broke this boy is. Look at this wall, and look at this raggedy-ass towel. I hope this is HD. You can see the fraying on the edge of the towel. He probably took this in a prostitution motel, knowing this type of person. Oh, and by the way, little buddy, if any of you guys think you want to play with me, trust me, you don't. I got a great team. So this is his family, the Ferris family. And here's the contact information for his family, you dig? This is Uncle phone number. And trust me, we can find more if we need to. So I'm going to just give you a warning shot. Let you know, sit your low ass down before you get hurt. Huh? Don't play with grown folks, boy, because we'll find you. Emilio the Armor won't write to cut heads off. Warrior King, easy. Genghis Khan, Julius Caesar, and this bitch. We burning the whole town to the ground. Now pay attention, because it gets worse. Now this is the next nerd. This is the nerd who took a photo of me while I was recording a video for my members. And he was so scared that he stood 3 football fields back and took the photo from the nosebleeds using a sniper lens on his camera. He was so far back. He took it from behind my back. Didn't even take it from my face. Was scared to say anything. Ooh, these nerds are something else. This is the guy. His name is Eric Spencer. He's at least 48 years old, which means he should know better than this, right? He damn sure should know better than to play with me. Let me show you guys. This is Eric's family right here. Huh? Now, mind you, any of you guys speak anything about my employees, my women, my people, I'ma come for you. You've been warned. This is his family right here. And look at this person right here. I'm not going to speak on it because I'm being nice. But when I get in that zone, gloves are off. I don't care. I talk about everybody. Your dead daddy, your dead grandma. I have no respect. Because for my enemies, I want your dick in the dirt. Smash that hand with a sledgehammer. But I'm going to give you a warning shot, sucker. Now, let's carry on. This dude is a senior citizen damn near. And I want him to know that. Don't come playing with the young boys, because the young boys still be wild, huh? I knock your block off, boy. And look, as I said, if you want to come get tuned up, after this live session, find me in front of the Fairmount Hotel, huh? It's very easy to find. You can find it on Google Maps. I'll be right outside in front. I'll be very visible. The guy with his shirt off, covered in sweat with his hands wrapped up. That's me. Roland Colehurst writes, I had to go out in the cold to get some Popeyes for this roast. Yeah, absolutely, man. We skewering these boys up, and we about to get them. Capri, shout out to the lady saying, you dig. Oh, even your mama showed up long. We got the fire cooking, you heard me? Sending in the euro. Oh, those the pounds. Hey, shout out to James. Now let me finish maxing these boys out. Hey, you guys would not believe this. Check this out. Look at this boy. He had the nerve to take a picture of the pimpin', and it was weird because he took a picture candid like he was a paparazzi or something. Now let me point out how tacky this boy is. Now he posed for this picture. Why did the person in the picture not tell him his collar was flipped up on his blazer lapel? Why didn't they tell him that? Why didn't they tell him his shirt collar was slipped to the side? This is his version of dressed up, huh? Now, why didn't they tell him that he has his pants cuffed at the bottom? Anybody who's super player knows if you got your pants tailored, you don't need to cuff them, huh? This boy is a bum. Why you're even talking to me, little homie? I don't know. You's a bum. You don't measure up in any way. I would slap you dead in your face in person, in a real way, homie. And when it comes to dressing, when it comes to women, when it comes to thinking, when it comes to education, professionalism, accomplishments, you don't measure up. I will dominate you in every way. So you can come find out if you want to. Hey, and check this out. They want to talk about the person holding the camera, who's irrelevant. When you come to roast the big homie, this is what you do. You roast the big homie. You don't roast nobody else. You roast me. The reason they can't roast me? Why? Look at me, huh? Boy, I'm pretty like Ali, boy. That's why they can't roast me. My credentials are impeccable, nerd. Now look at his girl. Let's talk about it. His girl looks tremendously old. Older than him, in fact. You can see wrinkles and crow's feet on the left. You see these signs of age around her mouth. The smile wrinkles. And this bitch is wearing a Canadian tuxedo. I kid you not. She got a goddamn denim dress shirt, and she had the nerve to pop the collar out from under this bum-ass sweatshirt. This is crazy. Yeah, he got the nerve to talk about the big homie. And then Yvette Bailey, who I assume is one of his relatives, we can find out. She writes, she's you. What the fuck is she doing with you? Those are the actual words. You can read it here. Wow, bruh. But you talking about me. Nigga, check my background, man. My hoes is... Nigga, I got more hoes than clothes. I got hoes on every continent, real talk, except Alaska. I'm trying to get me an Eskimo, bitch. Get it? Man, this boy is a real sucker. Robert writes, he's used to defend Brazilian working women like their firstborn kids. You ain't never lied. And labeled assassin as just a dating coach. It's a shame. When you're a life coach, these dudes are mutts. These dudes absolutely are mutts, and I ain't got a whistle. I ain't coaching a damn thing, you dig? I'm just trying to lead men to be great leaders of themselves. They ain't even got to follow me, you dig? Everything I talk is not about me. It's about you. Everything is centered on you. Three-sentence Bible. Sentence number one, be yourself. I never tell you to be me or even to follow me. I tell you to be yourself, which is to follow you. Follow what's inside of you. Sentence number two, be good to yourself. Sentence number three, be good to good people. So you might wonder, why am I dragging these fat... Ooh, almost got myself banned. Why am I dragging these individuals through the dirt? They're not good people. They're lowlifes. So they're going to get that work. You heard me? Shout out to Robert McKinney. Yeah! SX Moneymakers, right? You're going to give them that Scooby snack? Oh, man, I would love to, but here's the thing. We all know if they saw me two times, and I'm with a female, and they ain't got the guts to approach me when I'm with a female, when they see me outside covered in sweat looking like a bronze statue, huh? You think they can walk up to Ali like that? Nah, they don't want that work. That's why I'm inviting every single one of them. As soon as it's live in, I'm going to go ahead and get suited and booted, and I'll be right out there. So if any soldiers want to get recruited, go ahead and do your recruiting. Show up with your whole army. I'll knock them all flat, because one lion can deal with a multitude of hyenas. Absolutely. Sucker! Now, we ain't even done. We ain't even halfway through, because it gets worse. Trust me, you are going to want to watch this. Shout out to Confidence Creator. I tagged one of his videos on the community tag. Check the brother out. Genuine, intelligent man who has great, great investment in his content. Like, he's making good stuff. You did. He also made a little comparison with your boy, the guy we're going to roast, Nostradamus. Keep watching. Capri, shout out to the ladies saying, you dig, appreciate it, love, with your fine ass. Preston writes, keep applying pressure. Marquette, we want all the smoke. Oh, man. Yeah, bro. Absolutely. Absolutely, we're going to apply pressure. And we're going to bust the pipes. No homo. Yeah, check this out. We ain't done. Oh, we got so many super chats. I truly appreciate it, Saints. SX writes, he might have a Glock. Be careful. People don't fight fair nowadays. They don't, but these boys are suckers, man. I've been in the streets for a long time, man. Check my G-file. I could look in their eyes and see they terrified. Because I knew if they was real off the rip, when they saw me, they would have confronted it. Because I come from a place where people will confront you for no reason. I come from a place where if you walking down the street, and they don't like the way you look or the way you dress, they say, Blood, where you from? Blood, you look like you bad. Yeah, that's where I come from. So these suckers don't want no business. O'Shea, just a TMZ worker. Boy needs to relax. Oh, hey, I ain't even got to O'Shea. You guys are going to love this. I promise you. I promise you. Hey, any of those O'Shea fans or O'Shea himself, and his name ain't even O'Shea. I mean, was he Irish, right? No. When I finish this, I invite them to hop on. I invite them. They gonna be scared, but here, let me get back to this roast. Check this out. Shout out to Matthew Strudwick. Truly appreciate that. Now, carrying on. Oh, I just wanted to share this. So this nerd guy right here, Eric Spencer, ladies and gentlemen, he posted a photo of this automobile, which means that he's proud of it. To him, this is an accomplishment. This dude's a cold nerd, man. Like, this is not even a car to me, huh? Like, I bought my mom a Camaro just for her to have something to park and go to the freaking grocery store in. This is garbage. You took a photo and posted that online? You're trash, bro. You know we're near my level, little homie. You have no idea what kind of cars I was riding in my early 20s. Forget now, early 20s. I was riding cleaner than you. You're a loser, bro. Like, and I never took pictures of my car and posted them online like that. No, the only car I have posted, the picture of it posted online, it's a car that's a work of art. I don't even have regular car insurance for it. I have art insurance for it. Because it's a piece of art. I don't have to pay regular car insurance. Why? Because it's qualified to go in a goddamn museum. Real talk. Over half a century old in pristine condition, bro. Talk to me. You's a clown to me, homie. For real, though. And I mean every bit of that. And I would be so honored if you pulled up on me tonight. I swear to God I would. Now, let's carry on. Look at this nerd right here. And here's the thing. If you super player like me, you didn't did it all. I can recognize from a mile away this man is wearing what's called an adjustable band bow tie. And only suckers will wear an adjustable band bow tie. A real man who really has guap and class, you're going to wear a self-tie bow tie. The one that you actually tie by hand. But the reason this old-timer doesn't have one, he don't know how to tie one. Because he ain't got no class. He never been to a black tie affair. You dig? Man, I go to galas all the time. I tie one in my sleeve. This dude has an adjustable band bow tie. That probably went over a lot of people's heads. It's okay. Let's get back to this work. Look at this dude. He's wearing a sweater vest. This is sweater vest number two. I'm outraged. This is sweater vest number two. This dude looked like, he looked like the mailman from Mr. Rogers. I mean, this dude looked like an out-of-work librarian. This dude right here, he looked like a Jehovah's Witness. No disrespect to the witnesses, man, because they thorough. I don't need them showing up at my door. But look at this outfit. He has the nerve? I'm outraged. I'm appalled. I mean, like, how are you 50 years old? You're 50 years old, bro, and you're walking down the street when you should be enjoying yourself, taking pictures of me and posting it in a group with a bunch of grown men because you're mad because I said Brazilian women are overweight? And in actual fact, the buddy who roasted me said, I understand. You can listen to his video. He said, I understand what Marquette is saying. I've seen the same thing. Come on, man. This is real outrageous, but we're not done with these nerds. Okay, here's the contact information for his family members right here. We do have it. We will use it. And in fact, when I go to destroy you, boy, it will not be just a little thing. I will destroy everything you love, boy. I will destroy your source of income. I will destroy your family relations. I will destroy any romantic relations you have. I will destroy your reputation. I will destroy you, boy. I hope you understand how serious it is with me. Let me maximize my face. It's serious with me. And let me teach you a little something about a man who's a technologist. There's something called search engine optimization, which means that I have enough money and influence to create so many articles about you being a sucker that when people Google your name, which they never do, but if they did, they would find page after page after page of you being a clown. Huh? Now, let's get to the grand finale. Hey, if you ain't shared this link, share it right now. If you didn't like this video, like it right now. Let me know how many likes we got. I'm taking a commercial break right now, because these likes better be way up, because it's about to get hot. You dig? These likes better be way up, because it's about to get hot. Oh, we getting to the grand finale. Hey, let me know how many likes we got, because this is about to get brutal. Yeah. This is about to get brutal. Yeah. Let me know where we at with the likes. If the likes ain't there, I'm away, because this is about to get ugly. Y'all gonna love this. Y'all gonna love this. Yeah. You won't believe what I'm about to share. You're going to love this. Where the likes at? Let me know what it's at right now. If you haven't liked this, you better go ahead and like this, because you are going to love this information. And here's the thing. When I roast somebody, I don't tell jokes. I tell truth. I don't tell jokes when I'm roasting you. I tell truth. When they roast me, they got to talk about the person holding the camera. They can't talk about me, because my reputation's impeccable. Yeah. Living 3 decades almost as a G, boy. Yeah. And that's in business. That's in the streets. Anywhere you go. Yeah. In fact, there was a guy on his comments that wrote, I've seen Marquette in Baltimore. Huh? Heard him give many speeches. He's a good guy. Yeah. Yeah. That doesn't come from pretend. That comes from really living life. It's Blaze Rice, Peace to the Saints. It's Jonathan from upstate New York. Yeah, what it do, brother? Scorch them boys. I'm riding with you, Camp. They don't want no smoke. Hey, the funny thing is they don't even have the foggiest idea of how much they don't want the smoke. But they're going to learn. You know, they're going to learn. By the end of this one, they'll know. They'll know. Because I'm nothing to play with. And that's why you see a lot of these guys have never responded to me. And that was smart on their part. And the funny thing about O'Shea and his video, he's talking about, yeah, you roasted Kevin Samuels and you roasted so-and-so. Well, Kevin Samuels, I'm sure he can defend himself, number one. Number two, it wasn't a roast. It was just, again, an explanation of facts that have been omitted. He's not a businessman, and that's all we talked about. But you'll see the people in the comments, they're not addressing that because that's too much truth. They're going to something unrelated. They're talking about his relationship advice. That's not what I'm talking about. But hey, check this out. Let me know where the likes are. I'm not doing anything until we know how many likes are on this video. And if they write, then we're going to carry on. 470 likes? Oh, hell nah. Hell nah. Not after my team took out their time to put together the dossier that you've been seeing. Nah, nah, nah. I'm 700 likes. 700 likes. And you've never heard me say this before. If you follow me, you've never heard me say this before. So you should know this is going to be good stuff. There's 800 people on. There should be at least 700 likes. And you've never heard me say there's not enough likes. And the reason I say that, my team took out time to put together this information. And we are about to do one of the most brutal, truthful, accurate, far-reaching exposés that have ever been done on the internet. I promise you that. Dorian Smith writes, we cooking tonight. Well, hell, we might not get cooking. They ain't trying to throw the grease on the fire yet. You heard me? I told them to throw the lights on. We waiting on it. Yeah. Because they have no idea what's about to come. I want you guys, after this part, rewind and watch his video. And then look at his roast, what he calls a roast, and then look at this one. You're going to be like, damn. Yes, indeed. Check this out. Hey, all you suckers on there who are watching just to hate, you might as well go ahead and click the like, man. You can change it later. Click the like, because we ain't doing nothing until we got him up. Coach Scott Gately writes, I was going at it with this lame blogger, Toon. You got a lot of angry black dudes that dislike you. Hey, man, it don't matter, man. I've had haters my whole life. And I've learned to appreciate them. It's free promotion. Jabri writes, O'Shea is about to become one of the most exposed keyboard warriors of all time. Jabri, I'm telling you, bro, this is about to be a revelation, man. It's about to be a revelation. Yes, indeed. Woo-wee! Yeah, he said it right. Like the video, man. Should I just get up and leave and come back later? Jermaine Lewis writes, Kevin runs a YouTube channel. Isn't that a business? Thank you for asking that. And hey, I don't want to get off topic, so like the video so we can get to what we need to get to. Now, Jermaine, let me tell you this, Saint. Number one, the reason I roasted Kevin Samuels is because he was giving business advice. Not about becoming a YouTuber, but about running businesses. Businesses are systems. Systems that can operate without your direct activity. It's different than a practice, okay? Now, him being a successful YouTuber, that's a beautiful thing. I am personally proud of Kevin Samuels for his success in YouTube. I also want him to continue being successful. Truly. I truly do. Now here's the thing. He can't teach you how to become a YouTuber. It just can't be done. You can't teach someone how to be successful on YouTube at this late time. It's too late to the game. You'd be better off maybe trying TikTok, but still it's very difficult to be a content creator. And that's what he knows about. When you watch my video, you see I expose his background. He's never run a corporation. He's never run teams. He's a guy who worked at a perfume counter. I mean, let's be real here. Reason that's important is because when young men go to him trying to figure out how they make their first million, you make your first million with products and services in a business. A real business doesn't require your direct activity. I can go to sleep, wake up wealthier because other people have operated on my behalf. A business is a system. He is one who is engaged in a practice. Lawyers have a practice. A dentist has a dental practice. That means they actually have to do something. So say, I hope you comprehend what I'm trying to give you, a higher level of game. And I'm also saying, don't listen to him because he doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about. Okay? And if after this you want to ask another super chat, which is, hey Marquette, why are you qualified? Then we can look at some fucking footage of me going around the world and saying shit that's so important they have people translating it into 19 different languages simultaneously. Then you can ask me some dumb shit again as to why I'm qualified. Now, where are the likes at, Saints? Where are the likes at? Let me know what they're at right now. Muhammad writes, getting goosebumps, as you should, man. It's going to be a beautiful one. Kenny DeWooney says, do the super chat. Hey, Insanes, we got some real receipts on this boy. You hear me? I'm telling you, this boy is the biggest fraud ever. If I've ever called anybody a fraud, this man right here is a fraud. And we're about to get him, but we wait. Let me know where the hell the likes are. Come on. Where we at? 630? That's not enough. It's not enough. Oh, and by the way, man, there's this one hater. He's actually in the chat right now. It's beautiful. I'm not going to say his name, though. The funny thing is, the kid is such a nerd and a psychopath. I blocked him from the channel like 4 times. He keeps coming back with new screen names. This is mental health issues right here. It's really sad. He's a real psychopath. Good Lord. And I'm going to just go ahead and block him again right now. Best I can do, you dig? Now go ahead and get them likes up. Daniel Nuosu writes, 700 likes, let's go, Saints. And here's the thing, we got 877 people watching. That means that we can literally have 177 people sit out, not even do it, and still make it. So obviously somebody is sitting there and they just for some reason don't want to click the like button, but we ain't playing games today. My team worked too hard to put this together. And I am going to enjoy this. I want as many people to get this message as possible. Ooh, this is going to be a real vicious one, Saints. I really believe this will go down in YouTube history as one of the most brutal roasts ever. Because I'm putting all this business out there. Yeah, and this dude has been a real loser around the world. And I have the documentation for it, Saints. Like, real factual stuff. It's crazy. Yeah, and he thinks he can't be found. Like, he obviously hasn't studied my background. I've been all over the world, you dig? Like, I've been to the places that are really close to where he is right now. He's in Uganda. I've been to Tanzania, Kenya, Ethiopia, South Africa, Zanzibar. Oh, man, like, Dar es Salaam. Like, I can keep going. Yeah, and I have great business contacts throughout the continent. He can be found, and he shall be. He shall be. Indeed. I'm going to just wait till the likes get to where they're supposed to be, Saints. Yeah, we said 700 likes, and we can't budge on it. And I'm, matter of fact, I'm going to only give it 10 more minutes. If it ain't there in 10 minutes, I'm going to just call it a day. I'm going to finish the roast exclusive for members only. Because this is too good. This is too good. I don't ever ask for anything. Let's keep it real here. I don't ask for nothing. Nick of the Woods, right? I don't even care the other nerds as long as you get to Nostradamus. We all know what you're talking about. Oh, we're going to get there. And trust me, when I get there, you're like, damn, Quet. That was thorough. And just thank the team. You dig? Thank the team because they worked hard. Jay Trey writes, just like the video. Just like it. Let's get going. I already got to that one. Okay, cool. Yeah, let's see where we at with the likes. He said, I see 715. Okay. Hey. You know what? In the words of, how's he do his intro, that dude? In the words of that one bald head dude, my other bald head brother. Okay, fellas. Woo! I am Juice. Game time. Let's get it. Okay. Check it out. This nerd his name is Cornelius Deja. Red flag number one. What kind of real nigga? I repeat, what kind of real nigga's name Cornelius? Yeah. Yeah, we already in his ass. Keep it going. Cornelius Deja is his government name. Yeah. Now here's the photo that was posted by one of these nerds who was so scared he had to take the photo 3 football fields away from outer space. He took this photo from Pluto and posted it on Facebook. Then you have a gentleman who goes under an alias, meaning a fake name, because he's a coward. He writes, fuck it, I'm about to get him. Oh, really, little buddy? Little buddy? Nah, little fella, you ain't about to get nobody. And here's the funny thing. I hope you guys can see this, because what he doesn't realize is that his whole plan backfired. Yeah, he doesn't realize that. Let me see if I can zoom in on this for you. Let's see if that'll work. Yeah, there we go. I hope you guys can read that. Shows his whole plan backfired because he's a moron. Let's see if I can enlarge this a little bit. Jason, shout out, welcome to New Saint. He writes, quote, I learned about your channel from O'Shea. Fake name, his real name's Cornelius. I learned about your channel from Cornelius. He had a lot of negative things to say about you in a live roast. I've been watching your vids and you have great content. I'm curious to see if you'll bring out that sledgehammer for the end. Jason, you let me know what you think of this sledgehammer I got for him. Oh, then he follows up. I also subscribed, which means we have a new subscriber courtesy of Cornelius. So, Saints, as always, within the sass and this thing of ours, welcome Jason warmly to the greener grass. And now let's get to this work. Look at Nostradamus. This boy got the biggest nose I've ever seen. And here's the great irony, and I saw it in his comments. He wrote that the girl I was with is ugly, which is ironic because it was a photo of her back. But whether she was fat, stupid, and ugly, doesn't matter. Thought you were roasting me, but now I'm roasting you. First off, you're exceptionally ugly. And I don't say that as a joke. I say that as a point of fact. Now, if there are any women on the chat, I want you to go ahead and vote. Would you rather have this ugly person suffering from nostrilitis? I mean, this man's freaking nose is so big you could stick a baseball glove up his nose. His nostrils are so big you could look up and see his brain. This boy's nose is quite disgusting, and here's the reason he got mad. He has a video entitled, Is Brazil Worth Moving To for Black Men? He has a video called that. Well, why would he want to move to Brazil? Well, when you have a face that only a mother could love, you have a face for radio. Oh, I see why you moved to Brazil. Because you're too fucking ugly to get a woman in America. You gotta buy a woman because you're fucking morbidly ugly. Huh? And the worst thing, he's ugly, you'd think he'd at least get in shape. He's fat and ugly. Matter of fact, he's fat, stupid, and ugly, and I'm gonna show you the evidence. Carry on. Now, first off, let's get a good look at this nose. Literally, this nose... Hold on, Saints. Let me measure this. I mean, this is crazy. Let me measure this goddamn nose this motherfucker has. This nigga's nose on screen is like a whole 3 inches. Let me maximize it again. Damn, I almost feel like I gotta rate this video. Man, I mean, this is crazy. Look at this nose. Who lets this man call anybody ugly? Bruh, you need to sit down and be humble. With a face like that, you need to sit your ass down and be humble, bruh. This big nose bastard is probably happy that he gets to wear a COVID-19 mask. Cover his whole shit up from right here. He walk around, he might see a female. She might think he look alright because he got his whole shit covered up right here. Covered up that big ass nose. This is one of the ugliest motherfuckers I've seen in a long time. Now we know why he thinks Brazil's a good option for black men, because he can pay to play. The big nose, ugly bastard. Now, his government name is Cornelius Deja. What a clown. You's a real nerd, boy. Your mama named you Cornelius. Now here's the thing. I said you dumb, fat, and stupid. Oh, don't forget ugly. Don't ever forget ugly. That's clearly need not be said, but he's also stupid. Here's what happened. When you're in America and you want to go to medical school, you go to a prestigious university, like maybe say the Johns Hopkins University. That's a prestigious medical institution, top 5 on the planet Earth, little homie. So maybe you can't get into the Johns Hopkins, the Yale, or the Harvards of medical school. That's all good. Well, maybe go to a middle-tier medical school. Well, he couldn't get into an elite medical school. Couldn't get into a middle-tier medical school. He couldn't even get into a low-tier medical school. So what do you do if you're not good enough to get into medical school in America? Well, the first step, and I know this for a fact because I used to have an office at Johns Hopkins Medical. In the Armstrong building. I was the only person there with an office who didn't have a PhD. Work that magic out. That's first-rate brains, little buddy. Now, once you can't get into medical school in America, you try to go in the Caribbean, like the Bahamas or something like that. I also know because as a technologist, I run a company, and we deliver technology to these medical schools. Now, if you can't get into med school in America, you try the Caribbean. That's your second bet. Now, if you can't get into med school in the Caribbean, then you have to go somewhere else. But the reason you try the Caribbean, because they're English-speaking, and because they're close to America, they have the same standards, and it's easier to transfer your credentials back to America. But this dumb bastard is so idiotic and underqualified and imbecilic. I'm not even sure that's the word. Somebody check that out for me. But he's such a damn fool, he had to go way over to Poland just to get a medical degree. But here's the thing, he's so stupid, he ain't even got the goddamn degree. You can see gray hair in his beard. Look at his hairline, for Christ's sake. He got the Carl Winslow. He got all the Carls, Carl Winslow, Carl Malone. I mean, come on, bro, shave that shit off. He got the George Jefferson. Man, cut that shit off, man. Got that receding ass hairline, be saluting like this, man. You bullshit bum bastard. He went way over to Poland just to get a medical degree that he still hasn't finished. Here's the worst part. Poland's not even like a first-rate European country. No disrespect to anybody. I'm just talking about dynamism of the economy. Why do I know? Because I'm an international businessman. It pays for me to know. Poland's a second-rate European country. It's never been a European power. In fact, I'm pretty sure Poland was one of the first fucking places that Hitler crushed because it was easy work. Now, you're a bum bastard, went way over to Poland just to get a goddamn medical degree. Notice his history. He's too weak and ugly and fat and stupid to get a woman in America, so what does he do? He goes way across the world to Brazil and then brags about it because he's able to pay to get a woman. He's too stupid to get a medical degree in America. Then he's too fucking stupid to get a medical degree in the Caribbean because they won't let him in the med school, so it goes way over half the world to Poland. He was a dumb bastard. And then he's too stupid to complete the degree at age 50. And so he still didn't finish his degree. He's not a doctor. He has no proper credential. Oh, but it gets worse. It does get worse. Here's the worst thing. This dude is a bona fide criminal. But before we go on to that, let's look at his LinkedIn. Just real quick, you know? Real quick. See what kind of people we dealing with. You heard me? Now check this out. Oh, this is a bum bastard. Y'all are gonna have so many clips to cut up because this dude is a real loser, man. Yuck. Yuck. I even hate having his name in my mouth. Cornelius. Cornelius. I wonder how his parents used to talk to him. I bet his own mom had no respect for him. He's such an ugly individual. I bet when he was birthed, his mom looked at him, saw that enormous nose, and she was just so regretful about his father. I bet to this day she still hates his daddy. You got your daddy nose. Every time he do something wrong, his mom be like, see, you got your daddy nose. You big nose bastard. Now look at this, Saints. Let me show you again what broke looks like. And you know somebody's broke when they want to say, Marquette, I have more YouTube followers than you. But what about the bread, though? What about the guap, though? Speak Guapanese to me, you heard me? Now check this out. Cornelius Deja, that's his government name. You know it's him because it says he's a student in freaking Poland. What a nerd. Had to go way over there just to get a degree. Now let's look at his background. Here's the thing about me. I've been winning my whole life. Check my real background. I'm nothing like these internet nerds. I've never been a YouTuber. I've been real on the planet Earth in real life. Now, he used to work at Verizon. Apparently he still does because it says 2009 to the present. He works at Verizon doing sales in the mall. You know, when you're walking through the mall and somebody's like, hey, man, do you want a new iPhone? I can hook you up with a great plan. I can switch over carriers. No problem. He's that guy in the mall. He's selling cell phones and cell phone plans in the mall. Wow, bro. I would have did that job in high school. It's beneath me. You dig? Real shit. Because of who I am and who I've always been, nerd. Now, here's the thing. You want to find him back in 1999 or 2009, this old-ass nigga, phones. Come on, bro. You don't measure up. You don't measure up in any category. You're ugly, you're out of shape, and you're stupid. Well, on the other hand, I find myself to be the opposite of all of those things. Huh. In high school, I was voted best dress, best smile, and Mr. Irresistible. That's in L.A. County, bro. That's real shit. Well, you're extremely ugly. Look at your nose. Okay, now education, you are having to go out of the country just to get a basic degree, and I do consider a medical degree a basic degree to me, because I know a lot of physicians. You dig? And they're not geniuses, trust me. Now, continuing. Look at what a nerd looks like. He has his medical school listed, but he never graduated. Further, look at his bachelor's degree. Well, it says 2 years, 2005 to 2007. You got your degree in 2 years? I don't believe it. No, I don't believe it. But here's the funny thing. If you got a BA in 2007, we're over a decade later, you're trying to get into medical school and you're still not done? You're a loser, bro. Further, no disrespect, it's all beautiful to get education, but you went to California State University Sacramento? That don't even rank, little homie. That don't even rank, bro. You dirt to me, homie. You dirt in every area. You're dirt. Huh? You're dirt in every area. You don't measure up on anything with the big homie. Okay, carrying on. We just getting warmed up? Shit. Now check this out. Let me do this new screen share, and this is about to blow your mind. This is about to blow your mind. Now, I want you guys, if you don't think I'm about to blow your rabbit ass mind right now, believe me, man, you gonna say, "Quet, I didn't know you had juice like that to find out all this shit." I do. I really do. Check it out. Here we go. Let's work. Let me enlarge this because I need you to see the verity of this document. I just pasted this. You know, I didn't paste this. My team pasted this. This is a screenshot, as you can see. What's the nerd's name? His name is Cornelius Dacia. Cornelius Dacia. Who is this? Dacia versus the Louisiana State Board of Nursing. This nerd tried to become a male nurse unsuccessfully. Well, you might say, well, gee, Mark, why couldn't the nerd become a male nurse? I'm about to tell you why the nerd had trouble becoming a male nurse. And it's a goddamn shame. Pay close attention. Hope you're recording. Dacia versus the State of Louisiana Board of Nursing. He's a defendant. You might say, well, gee, Marquette, why is he a defendant? Do you have to be a defendant to become a freaking male nurse? Quote, this is direct quotation. While plaintiff disclosed several instances, including the intoxication-related charges, meaning this dumb bastard is catching cases while being on intoxicants, drugs, or alcohol. Now here, you know I love you guys because I'm constantly telling you to stay away from intoxicants. I have a whole video talking to you about not using any intoxicants. That's true love for you. You see where it leads you to bad outcomes like this dumb bastard. Now, this, I'm going to continue on. Continuing on. We're talking about Cornelius Dacia. He disclosed several instances, including intoxication-related charges. He apparently did not disclose his arrest. Oh, we dealing with a jailbird here. I didn't know Cornelius was a thug. Okay, to disclose his arrest for grand theft? What? My nigga stealing cars? Lock your shit up. Hey, we still got LoJack? We need some LoJack, this bum-ass nigga. And obtaining property under false pretenses, okay? But it gets worse, Saints. For being under the influence of a controlled substance, we not talking about no alcohol. We talking about something worse. This boy be on the poly, what they call Molly Percocet? This boy be on that nose candy. Now just imagine how much cocaine you can sniff. I gotta go back on Big Street. Imagine how much cocaine this boy can sniff with a nose like he got. Look at this boy, so ugly. His nose is so I'm telling you, the boy's nose was crazy. With a nose like that, you know how much cocaine this man can sniff? You remember that last scene of Scarface when they had that brick of cocaine and he just put his face all up in it? This nigga can sniff a whole piece of cocaine up one nostril, bruh. So I can only imagine how high he was. But let's go back to the facts. Now let's go back. Them big old nostrils. He Nostradamus. A student of nostrology. Okay, look. For being under the influence of a controlled substance, so the boy is a cokehead. For burglary, my nigga, burglary? He's a burglar? He looked like the Hamburglar if anything. This fat nigga is the If he burglarized anything, this nigga that broke into a Wendy's, you didn't think it's a hamburger and a fat bastard. He then broke into a Wendy's with a King Coke up one nostril, eating hamburgers, getting busted on camera. Now, let's go back to it. Let's talk these facts. Okay, and evading a peace officer, I gotta respect your fat ass. Your fat ass and tried to run from the police. Your fat ass and tried to run from the woods and got caught, apparently. And it looks for driving at an unsafe speed. Oh, this nigga was in a high-speed chase. We might see this nigga on World's Dumbest Criminals. And for, oh, here's the worst part. Yeah, pay close attention to this right here. Now, you wonder why these nerds gotta go abroad just to find a woman? These nerds hate women, huh? See, me, I might dog out a harlot who's promiscuous or has low values, but I love women. Women have brought me in abundance. I appreciate a good woman. I love a true lady. Nothing but respect. I give nothing but service, and in turn, she serves me. You dig? Know how to show respect to a boss. Now, look at these suckers right here, huh? Now, check out what kind of sucker Cornelius is. This is from a court document, okay? It says, inflicting corporal injury on his spouse. Cornelius is a woman beater. Cornelius Deja. O'Shea Duke Jackson. You lying rat piece of trash. You are a woman beater. Now, I dare you to beat on me, little buddy. Huh? You bring your fat body. You bring that big nose. Can you imagine how much blood would flow out of that big nose once I crush it with my mighty fist? Can you imagine? What?
He's got a live about to go about you, and he's telling people all this happened in the 80s, but there's dates on that website if you pulled up that happened in 2009. He's telling people this happened in the 80s.
So he's on the live right now trying to clear his reputation. Oh, he's about to go live. Okay. He's about to go live claiming that that happened in the 80s. It says, I used to beat women in the past. I used to be Ike Turner in the past. Yeah, nah, nigga. You're a woman beating sack of shit, boy.
The website shows
happened. Yeah, it's all good. Oh, you said the website shows the dates.
2009.
And it's 2009. Yeah, my people got you, little boy. So don't you play with me, you little sucker. And you're a wife beater. I'm gonna catch you and beat your ass one day. And you know what? I'm gonna beat your ass with the mighty fist of God on behalf of all of the women you have wronged. You big-nosed, woman-hating piece of shit. And you hate women because you're fucking ugly, okay? Now, you guys have all seen this man is a wife beater. Or a woman beater inflicting corporal injury, meaning fucking physical punishment, to his spouse. And here's the funny thing at the end of it. Plaintiff was denied a license to practice as a registered nurse. Well, shocker. They don't want woman beaters being nurses. I'm not shocked. Okay, and here's the other thing to understand. Because he couldn't do it in America, because he has all these fucking cases in America for being a sack of shit, oh, he had to go over to Europe. And now he's in Uganda. But let me tell you what he's doing in Uganda. Oh, it gets worse. It gets worse. Woo. So, oh yeah, by the way, here's the source. We got sources for all this stuff. This dude's a bum. But oh yeah, check this out. If you go to BitChute, you can watch a video of him. Go to minute 21, second 24, and you can see this ugly rascal literally admitting to being a trick. Admitting to paying for sex from women in Uganda, which is a country in sub-Saharan Africa that has a significant HIV/AIDS rate among people in the sex industry, as you could expect really anywhere in the world. But particularly dangerous there because of the health standards. So your dumbass goes to sub-Saharan Africa, to Uganda, to engage in sex tourism, and what's worse, you get busted, and the reason you get busted is because you were doing weirdo shit there. And I'm going to tell everybody what you were doing, you ugly, fat, big-nosed sack of shit. Here's the thing, Saints. Oh, and shout out, Nate. I truly appreciate the super chat, man. We putting this boy on Front Street all the way. Hey, look at this boy. He's all of the Carls. Carl Winslow and Carl Malone. Good. Can somebody call up LeBron James and tell him we have found someone with a worse hairline? Look at this ugly sack of shit, and look at that nose in the middle of his face. Even if he had a nice, well-sculpted nose, like, I don't know, like this one. Even if he had a nice, well-sculpted nose, he's still fucking ugly. He didn't even have an upper lip. What kind of black man has no upper lip? You fat, ugly weirdo, and he's balding? Bro, you're garbage. Now, check this out. Check this out. It gets worse. It gets worse. It gets worse. Your mother, and this is from your mama, writes, why would you even follow a man who looks like that? That's the water. I'm over here tripping out like, how is this ugly guy calling someone that I'm with who's recording me? How's he calling them ugly? If I were him, I would never call anyone ugly. I wouldn't. I would never call anyone ugly. And if you followed me, I've already told you, man, I don't care how a woman looks. Man, my bad bitches. I mean, just check on me, man. I got more hoes than clothes, man. As I speak, I'm probably getting DMs from hoes. Real shit. Ball Bro writes, just take my money. I feel guilty watching this for free. You heard me? Because all the research that went into this shit. I got paid employees doing this shit. You heard me? Give back to the people. I appreciate it. Shout out to Ball Bro. Shout out for the super chat. Yeah. And Millie, shout out to Shorty. She writes, ugly people always do. Which is to say, these ugly boys is always out here beating on the female. And here's the funny thing, him and his buddies, I invite them to come try to beat on me, because I'm going to be right outside the Fairmount Hotel doing pull-ups, jump rope, and shadow boxing for about 2 to 3 hours. You can even come at the end of my workout. You have a better chance. I'll be a little more tired. But as you know, I don't get tired. But you have a little better shot at me, baby. I will be here. Open for business. Bryce writes, the O'Shea people saying it's his dad. Okay. Sure. That's the guy you guys want to follow. Okay. All right. Sure. Let me show you something that's not his dad. Hold on. Don't worry. My people do great research. Let me show you something that's not his dad. Brother Ray writes, bless a trick's heart. Without the tricks, this pimpin' will show enough star. Woo! Hey, did you hear that one? Oh, shout out to the pimping. Oh, I love that. And that's why they hate me deep in their heart. They hate me because they got to pay to play. They go up to a woman, and because they're so ugly in the face and they're so decayed in the heart, they're so vile and disgusting on the inside, and their bodies are broken and feminine because they have so much fat tissue. They got to pay to play. But when the pretty pimping walk up, you heard me? She could lay everything on me for free, you dig? She give me everything I want and more that I don't want. Hey, and here's the thing, she gonna pay me with your money, little buddy. Steven writes, paying tuition, all gas, no brakes, absolutely. And it's easy to go hard when you ain't got a fear or a care in the world. Boy, I stand tall all throughout the planet Earth, man. I'm everywhere like air, you dig? I'm even telling these boys what hotel we at. They can come meet me. Don Stevens, Christ, dang, say you ain't right. Oh, I'm totally right. What's not right is this man beating women. And let me show you what's not right that he's also doing. This boy is a bona fide fruitcake. He's been eating Fruity Pebbles. Hey, gotta talk about it. Let's see. Just observe his face, though. Come on, man. And he got the nerve to wear a wife beater? Well, I guess him wearing a wife beater makes perfect sense, Marquette, because he's a wife beater. Damn. I just blew my own mind with that one. Damn, it's a revelation. He's wearing a wife beater, and he is a wife beater. That's curious. Okay, carrying on. Check this out. I told you this boy's a weirdo. Here's a website. Africa says no to sodomy. You guys know what sodomy is. Sodomy is when you're mud packing, when men are mud packing each other. Or not men, when males are mud packing each other. Yeah. This means when a guy, for some reason in his brain, gets confused and decides to anally penetrate another guy, that's sodomy. In every religious text, the punishment is capital punishment, death. In the Torah, among the Jews, the Bible among the Christians, the Quran among the Muslims, it is death. May someone bring this man to justice. May someone bring this man to justice. Now, let me show you how weird this boy is. Yeah. He's doing such weird things in Uganda, sodomizing transvestites, for example. Africa says no to sodomy, makes a post about this boy. American YouTuber O'Shea, I wish they'd have used his real name, Cornelius. O'Shea's a sex tourist. There you go. In and out of Uganda, meaning he's come back multiple times, promoting sex tourism to American men to come to Uganda to pay for sex. Now, let me tell you something about underdeveloped countries. When people go to underdeveloped countries, like Brazil has a dynamic economy, for example, but when you want to go way over to Uganda, where it's corrupt because of the poverty, and it's underdeveloped in many ways compared to a dynamic economy like, say, America or Brazil, well, you're going there so you can get away with things. And he's going there to get away with sodomizing children, sodomizing male children, and sodomizing transvestites. That's why he's listed on a website about sodomy. and it has his picture on there. Is that his daddy too? For his mindless followers who have no conscience, who have no integrity moral, is that his daddy too? Who's on this image on a website that's against sodomy? This boy's sick. Man, this boy's sick. I hope somebody brings some religious justice to this boy. Yeah. And let us end this. Let us end this just looking at his pitiful face right here. This is the face of a man who has just been bodied. This is the face of a man who is a sick pervert. A man who beats women. A man too stupid to get into medical school anywhere in the West. A man who has been convicted of committing illegal acts on this soil under the influence of drugs. A man who's a wife beater, a man who's a child molester, a man who's a transvestite sodomizer. A real pervert. Now, you got the gall to talk about me? Boy, I should give you some justice. Hey, and for all the religious people out there, make a prayer tonight that he gets the justice he deserves under God's law. Or even under the law of man, whoever can lay the first hand, you dig, and let that hand be merciless. Well, everyone, R.I.P., rest in peace to Shay Shay. Rest in peace to Cornelius. He has now been bodied.